Premier Zhao and distinguished guests, this house has been the scene of many an historic occasion, and tonight we celebrate another milestone. Premier Zhao, you are the first Chinese head of government to visit the United States, and we're honored to welcome you. The magnitude of America's esteem and respect for Chinese civilization may not be fully understood in China today. As a boy going to school in a small town in our Midwest, I learned of the venerable Chinese culture, and it seemed then that China was a million miles away. Today, our children are still taught about the great contributions that China has made. And yet, as we approach the 21st century, our young people think of your country as only hours away by jet plane. Technology has made us neighbors. It's up to us to make certain that we're also friends. Mr. Premier, your visit gives me the opportunity to express the great value I place on the positive and expanding ties between our two countries. Our cooperation helps the well-being of both our peoples to blossom and serves the cause of world peace. Goodwill and friendship do not always, as we found, bring agreement on every issue, but friendship gives us the freedom to disagree, even to criticize, without fear of lessening cooperation in our many areas of mutual interest. Let us always remember that open and frank dialogue is the foundation that supports the bridge between us. Mr. Premier, I remember well our last discussions in Cancun 2 years ago. I am grateful for the progress that we've made since then and look forward to even greater cooperation in the years ahead. I'm particularly pleased with the wide-ranging and constructive discussions that we enjoyed today. It was certainly a promising omen for the future and a positive way to begin a new year. Of course, the Chinese New Year will not come for several weeks, but this past Year of the Pig has proven that we can feast together at the table of cooperation. There's reason for optimism, but we must look past tomorrow and the day after and prepare with mutual trust and confidence for the next century. The bonds between our two proud and independent nations can be made a wellspring of hope and progress, of security and prosperity. We've been watching with interest and admiration your efforts to modernize by offering incentives to your people and stimulating economic competition. We have been pleased to contribute what we could as you expand the vistas of economic opportunity for the Chinese people. Tonight, we congratulate you, Premier Zhao, for the part that you're playing in the rebirth of China's economy. Before ascending to your current position, you were a leading force in turning around the economic decline of Sichuan. Under your guidance, the province went from stagnation to vibrancy, from hunger and food importation to abundance and the export of grain. In fact, I understand that because of the work you did there, it is said in China, if you want rice, go see Zhao. Ladies and gentlemen, to give you an idea of the significance of the Premier's economic achievements, Sichuan Province, which the Premier managed for 4 years before moving to Beijing, has 100 million people, making it the most populous province in China and bigger than all but seven of the countries of the world. The Premier is now putting that same creativity to work on a national basis. Premier Zhao is also known for his personal commitment to vigorous physical exercise. Tonight, I would ask all of you to join me in a toast to his health and to the health of China's other distinguished leaders and to peace, prosperity, and friendship between the Chinese and American people.
总统先生、李根夫人、女士们、先生们，首先，我对总统阁下刚才所发表的友好的讲话表示衷心感谢。我对贵国的访问从一开始就受到了热情的接待，今晚我应邀出席这个隆重的国宴，深感荣幸。 请允许我代表我的同事，并且以我个人的名义，向里根总统和夫人、向美国政府和各界朋友表示衷心的感谢。5年前，中美关系实现正常化，给两国人民带来了很大的喜悦，对世界形势产生了深远的影响。5年来， 中美关系经历了一段曲折的过程，既有多方面的发展，也遇到一些困难和障碍。中美关系的颠簸不定，不符合两国人民的利益，也不符合世界和平的利益。我希望这种不稳定的局面早日结束。发展中美关系是我们双方的共同愿望。我很赞赏里根总统说过的， 中美两国注定要通过合作变得更加强大，而不是由于分歧遭到削弱。我相信，中美两国人民都希望通过共同的努力增进友谊，而不愿意让分歧发展到破坏我们友谊的基础。中美之间的主要分歧， 或者说中美关系发展的主要障碍是台湾问题。我希望双方能够严格遵守历次中美公报中共同确定的指导两国关系的准则，履行各自承诺的义务，使我们之间的分歧得到解决。今天的世界依然动荡不安，两大军事集团的对峙更 更加尖锐，南北矛盾尚待解决，侵略战争的火焰在一处还没有熄灭，在另一处又燃烧起来。严峻的现实使我们大家都不能不为世界的前途担忧，同时这也增加了一切爱好和平的国家和人民对维护世界和平的责任感和紧迫感。中国 愿意同他们一起，为缓和国际紧张局势、制止军备竞赛、反对强权政治、维护世界和平而共同努力。中国一向反对军备竞赛，特别是核军备竞赛，主张全面禁止或彻底销毁核武器。我们早就宣布， 中国绝不首先使用核武器。我们对其实行的不扩散核武器条约持批评态度，但我们不主张、不鼓励核扩散，自己也不搞核扩散，不帮助其他国家发展核武器。凡是真正有助于实现海裁军、自制海军备竞赛 或消除核战争威胁的倡议，我们都采取积极支持的态度。中国是一个发展中的社会主义国家，奉行独立自主的对外政策。我们一贯主张国家不分大小强弱，应该以利平等、互相尊重、和平共处。我们愿意同世界上各个国家发展友好关系。我这次 到贵国来的一个主要目的就是探讨进一步促进中美友好关系的可能性。我今天已经在坦率、友好的气氛中同里根总统和他的几位内阁成员进行了会谈。通过这些会谈，我们增进了相互了解，双方都表示愿意进一步发展中美关系， 都认为在经济技术合作方面存在着巨大的潜力，并愿意采取积极态度进一步加强合作。我衷心希望 我的这次访问和李根总统10月份的中国的访问能够促进中美关系在互相尊重主权、互利同安争、互不侵犯、互不干涉内政、平等、互利和平共处五项原则的基础上稳定持久地向前发展，以造福两国人民、有利世界和平。
我的最后一段呢，还请翻译一下，有原稿子有点改动。There's some, ladies
and gentlemen, there's some change in the last paragraph, so I have to translate it. Today, I have had talks with President Reagan and some of his cabinet members in a friendly and candid atmosphere. These talks have helped to enhance our mutual understanding, and both sides have expressed the desire to further develop Sino-US relations. We both agreed that there are great potentials for economic and technological cooperation between our two countries and are willing to take a positive attitude to further increase our cooperation. I sincerely hope that my visit and President Reagan's visit to China in April will help to promote steady and durable growth of Sino-US relations on the basis of the five principles of mutual respect for sovereignty and territorial integrity, mutual non-aggression, non-interference in each other's internal affairs, equality and mutual benefit, and peaceful coexistence. This will serve the interest of our two peoples and that of world peace.
请允许我举杯，为李根总统和夫人的健康，为布什副总统和夫人的健康。
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.